So we continue our discussion further as our attempt is to understand the basic building block inside the Arduino, that is the CPU. This is a general discussion with respect to CPU. Only thing is that I am taking some names of the internal components or internal structure of 8085, which predominantly ruled the few decades in the last century. So once again I would recap what happens when the system is made on. Number one, this memory consists of some, so I think that our understanding of entire system is at somewhat broader level, not too broad but not too narrow also. So there, what is very clear with us to a satisfactory level such that there is no need to go further deep. And what is memory? Memory block is consisting of 2^n memory locations, where n is 16 here. So with the help of 16 address lines, the memory can be addressed. One can write into the memory at any location, one can read any memory location. The memory itself consists of some such locations which are fixed, that is, the data there remains throughout even though power supply is made off. That is called as read-only memory, and that cannot be written into. That also need not be today's reality. It is possible that you can write and there can be a location which will store data even if power goes off. There will be some location which will not store data if power goes off. So what is important is that there are some locations which contain fixed data which can be changed either while manufacturing or by some other method. Few locations are there, the data contained can't be predicted when the system is made on. But once you write, that remains at that, stored at that location as long as power supply is there. Power supply pins are not shown because we assume that every component in digital system is having +5. Nowadays there can be a low voltage level logic, but we assume, we restrict ourselves to be a working at a +500 ground level. So as discussed earlier, what is a CPU? The CPU 8085, or for that matter any other microprocessor or microcontroller chip it may be, it is ultimately constructed using the components like gates only. Gate is the basic component. Then flip flop is also made using gates. Arithmetic logic unit is also made, and there is adder, subtract is also made using gates. So everything is made using gates. Then what is the difference? Now one will say that what, human body is comprised of some kind of cells. Like that other bodies are there, then cell is comprised of atoms like that. So what is great in human body? But there is some fundamental difference on which human being behaves differently than others. Like that, a small circuit or small system consisting of gates, then when we give feedback it is a sequential circuit. So a digital circuit which does not include microprocessor and a digital circuit which includes a microprocessor, there is a fundamental difference is that when we talk of a sequential circuit, those who might have seen video might have understood something. Right now, the way in which we are teaching, actually I should engage few more sessions, even though the syllabus stipulates 2 hours per week, the syllabus is heavy. Therefore, if I decide to cover everything in detail, time will not be sufficient. If I decide to cover in available time, then you will not understand. Therefore, and that is not for my subject, the manner in which the advancement is taking place in all technical subjects is at so rapid rate that it is the teachers are finding it difficult to precisely define the contents to be put in a compact form in this stipulated hour for want of time. You may be aware of Gandhiji's letter. Gandhiji has wrote a 6-page letter to his friend. And at the end of the letter, what he said, since after writing a 6-page letter, which might have taken 1 hour for writing, Gandhiji said, as I did not get sufficient time, I could not make the letter short. Remember, most important thing. As I could not, Gandhiji wrote 6 pages in an hour and said that as I could not get the time because of my busy schedule, I could not make the letter short. So a 1-page letter to his friend would have required, say, 5 hours, and Gandhiji had only time of 1 hour. So he wrote a 6-page letter, because writing may take some time, like that talking, I am talking with you, takes time, but to contain it precisely in the available time is not so easy. And I think that instead of doing that, students may spend some extra time, and anyway, now it is not face to face. So if it is face to face, then getting time of all students simultaneously is difficult, but now you can watch at your leisure time, so that I am trying my level best to ensure that this background discussion, once this is over, then I may rush through, because I have put some tutorials in the group, that is the spoken tutorials. There, its programming and all that is advanced high school level work to some extent, as regards to using is concerned. Using effectively is something different. So let us spend this lecture and maybe one more lecture to understand CPU working. And once CPU working is very clearly known, I think most of the crux of the subject gets over. Then first 2 modules, which are actually required to understand a background for Arduino, but for laboratories is Arduino is there, we jump to the CPU architecture. So difference between a circuit, a digital circuit which does not include microprocessor and which includes microprocessor is described as below. A circuit which does not have feedback, a digital circuit which does not have feedback, is a plain circuit. It is having fixed inputs, fixed outputs, and for given input condition, output is same. So there is no much complexity involved. But when there is a feedback comes into picture, the same circuit can be in multiple states. Same circuit can be in multiple states, and depending upon how the things flow, the circuit will behave differently. Now, microprocessor can be said to be a further enhancement of a sequential circuit, wherein when we permit something to change depending upon the instructions which it reads, then it can be of infinite combinations. Just like a chessboard contains only 64 places and 32 pieces, but since the steps which are taken are interdependent and based on one another, there can be infinite combinations, like say in the case of microprocessor. So what microprocessor can do, we have discussed. Number one is some kind of arithmetical operation, say addition, then increment, then complement, then some kind of copy instruction, say for example copy or data transfer. These are data processing. There are some data transfer instructions. Say for example, one instruction might be move C comma B. So whatever is here, that is moved from B to C. then what can be there? You can bring something from memory to inside, and from inside you can store something into some memory location. So there are two instructions only we will take. One is called as load accumulator. So bring data from some memory location to accumulator. So whether the description is enough? Suppose if I tell you that you go to the hostel and bring the contents, or we can say some article there, to me. If I say that you go to the hostel and bring article which is available there to me, then the next question would be, hostel is very big, so where to go, which room number? So load accumulator from address, say 4000. So 4000 is hex. So hexadecimal number system is there. Even if you know it's fine, I think most of you must be knowing. Even if you don't know, it doesn't matter much. Some address you can say. So data at memory, one byte is of two digits. Digits include 0 to 9 and A, B, C, D, E, F. So 0 to F is one digit. So 8 bit means two digits. 16 bit means four digits. So load accumulator from address 4000. So what this microprocessor will do? It will get the data at location 4000 and it will put it in the accumulator. And then another thing, store accumulator contents as 5000. So if I execute these two instructions in sequence, the data here at 4000 will go to accumulator and that will be copied to 5000 computers. So it is just like data transfer in the memory, in the external memory. Right? So these are various operations. So in the last lecture we have seen, say, add instruction, add C, we have studied increment D, we have studied complement accumulator. So these are various instructions, various operations are to be performed, and for that there is opcode, operation code. So each instruction having an opcode. So add C, one opcode, increment D, one opcode, move C count B, one opcode, load accumulator one opcode. But load accumulator just by means some operations are there which are complete when they describe, but load accumulator operation is incomplete. So load accumulator is having some opcode. For 885 the opcode is 3A, but when 3A is the opcode read, what is further needed is from where to read. So next two locations contain the address. So the instruction is 3 byte length instruction, 1 byte for opcode and 2 bytes for operand. So like this, now we proceed further. So what happens is, now listen very carefully. After you reset, the system starts. When you do reset and then make reset low, the CPU starts. Now start, just like I in the last lecture I have told that the schedule, suppose you decide to maintain a diary and from tomorrow you want to be obedient and very systematic, disciplined person, then you already put what you are supposed to do tomorrow in the diary. But when you wake up tomorrow, what you have to do is go to the diary and read the first instruction. That must be hardwired within you. That can't be written anywhere. That you must store it in outside, not in the diary. So after you wake up, automatically, that is your construction. Somehow you have made your, what we can say, mind and body to go to the diary when you wake up. Similarly, when microprocessor is reset, the program counter becomes 0. Program counter becomes 0000. Then after you wake up, can you write something? No, why? Because there is nothing to write. First thing is you should read. So after reset, the program counter becomes 0000, and then the first, what is machine cycle? In 3 clock cycles, one operation of 885 is complete. 3 clock cycle is one machine cycle. So in the first, so once this machine cycle concept is there, almost everything of the microprocessor structure is understood now. So in the first machine cycle, what we will do? So I am trying my level best to explain to you so that you understand the broad description of working of CPU. Suppose even if there are some difficulties in understanding, it doesn't matter, because this is not there for your examination as such as it is. This is a broad theme with which you should be appropriately exposed, you should be aware of. In our introduction session, I think I could not hold till now, but I will be holding it on Saturday, Sunday, what we can say, club division wise. There I will elaborate more. So, after reset, what happens? After reset, the first cycle microprocessor, so in the one machine cycle, microprocessor will either read or write something. So in the first machine cycle, what would be? It will be read cycle. When it is read cycle, what will come on address lines? Data lines. So now I think if you understand this, you should consider to be super experts in knowing microprocessors, because that I think that covers almost everything. Nothing remains to be understood now. So first is a, I think I will save the space, type of the cycle. First is type of the cycle. It is read or write. Then when it is a read cycle, so what microprocessor can do? What microprocessor can do is very limited as regards to outside things are concerned. It will have only two cycles, a read cycle or a write cycle. If it is a read cycle, address will be given by microprocessor, read bar control signal will be made 0 by microprocessor, this memory will put something on the lines that microprocessor will accept and use that data further. Now for read cycle, who should give address? Right now, address is given by program counter. Program counter gives address. After reset, in the first cycle, it is a fixed cycle. Program counter gives address, and that address right now is 0000. Then data will come. So at location 0, something is stored. Initial part of the memory is normally called as EEPROM. It is old convention, but it is pre-stored. It will remain as it is. It will not change. So even if system is made on, it will start in the same manner. So whatever data comes, that data, where will go? Data after reset, the first cycle is a read cycle to know what to do. So that is an opcode. Data is to be interpreted to know what instruction. So this instruction decoder ID is most important component. Data will go to ID. Instruction decoder. So in the reads, always microprocessor will control the memory. So address will always be given by microprocessor. If it is read cycle, data will go to, this is destination, because microprocessor will read data, data will go to ID. In case of a write cycle, which we will see later on, it is microprocessor will give data. So here, what we can say, data, it will go to, so this arrow is not required, or here to be precise, PC will give, right? So I can make it more elaborative. So here we can have, so it is total now time. Type read, it is program counter. Program counter giving, and it would be obviously 0000 because it is after reset. Program counter will give. Program counter will give 0000. Then what will come on data lines? Something which was stored. What was stored there? Let us say 3A. If 0000 location stores 3A, that will go to instruction decoder. That will go to instruction decoder. I'll make it with black. So 3A. Is it clear now? So see, we are discussing it to such a level. I am trying my level best to emboss it onto your intellectual plane that you will never forget it, even if you try to forget. Just like tattoo, once the tattoo is embossed, you have to have a plastic surgery to remove that. So unless I am trying to explain it to such details with such kind of bombardment on you, that once you understand, you will never forget, even if you try to. You have to go to some kind of a psychiatrist and need a treatment to forget it. So try to understand the thrust. So we are not leaving a single missing link. So after reset, Microsoft provides you the address 0000 that appears on address lines. Microprocessor makes a read cycle, means read bar will be low. The data 3A is stored at address 0 that appears on data lines that is available to microprocessor, and that is taken as an opcode. 3A, it is going to instruction decoder. Opcode goes to instruction decoder. Then what Microsoft should do now? So remember, I am giving everyday examples. So once you decide that you want to be a structured individual, once you decide that you are a structured individual, in that case, what is required is, you should only define that you will read the diary when you wake up. The only thing which must be there, hardwired, fixed in you, is that you should read the first instruction in the diary. So before, when you decide to have to plan a new structured life, I am sure that everybody of you will be planning it from tomorrow morning. When you plan to have a new structured life, so what is to be done tomorrow, you have already done, right, from instruction 1, activity 1. So with what determination you need to go to bed tonight? That I will read the diary when I wake up tomorrow. So that is only thing which must be memorized by you within yourself. Like that, what microprocessor should do after reset? Read the memory location 0 and treat it as an operation code. Reading is done for multiple purposes. Of that, it is treated as opcode. Then what next? once you wake up tomorrow, only thing which you should do on your own automatically is to go and open the diary for activity number one. What is to be done there, what is to be done afterwards is already written in the diary. So do that. If that is, and your actions will be different depending on what is written there. So first cycle is a read cycle, and that is called as read into bracket phage, because that is, I am reading it for opcode. I am reading it for opcode. So it is a special cycle. So part of read cycle, fetch, normal read and opcode read. So 3A is operation code of some operation. Each operation is having some code. So 3A is the operation code for a data transfer instruction load accumulator. It is operation code for data transfer instruction load accumulator from memory from address 4000. LDA, 3A is the opcode of LDA. So load accumulator is a 3 byte instruction. Means what the instruction tells? Instruction tells, 3A tells the microprocessor that it is expected to read one memory location and put that data into accumulator. Which memory location? That memory location whose address will be there in next 2 bytes of the instruction. So what will happen? Once you listen very carefully, if you understand, it's fine. Even if you don't understand right now, what I would like to suggest is that you try to remember it somehow in a half understood manner. You might be knowing that buffaloes and cows, what do? They eat the entire cattle. They eat the entire, what we can say, food which is given to them, cattle feed. They are unable to eat it properly when it is available. The grass is there, put before the buffaloes. They are unable to eat it completely. But what do? They just try to capture every entire grass which is put before them, keep it with themselves, and at a leisure time, they again bring it out and eat. In Marathi, I will explain, because it is a very peculiar process. तर गाई म्हशी ही जी जनावर आहेत, पाळीव प्राणी आहेत, ते काय करतात? तेव्हा जेव्हा आपण चारा घालतो, तेव्हा जर चारा खायला त्यांना वेळ उपलब्ध नसेल तर ते पटपटपट खाऊन घेतात, मध्ये ठेवतात, आणि पुन्हा सवड मिळेल तसं बाहेर घेऊन पुन्हा खातात, रवंथ करणे म्हणतात. सो लाईक दॅट यू ट्राय टू, वेन आय एम टॉकिंग यू आर लिस्निंग, यू ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड. इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टँड, द ऍडव्हान्टेज वॉट वी गॉट बिकॉज ऑफ रेकॉर्डेड लेक्चर्स इज ऍट द बॅकग्राऊंड प्लेन यू मे थिंक फॉर सम टाइम अँड यू कॅन वन्स अगेन वॉच द व्हिडिओ सो दॅट द कंटेंट शुड बी व्हेरी क्लिअर. सो इट इज 3A. सो आफ्टर 3A, what when the 3A goes to instruction decoder, what instruction decoder we understand? Again, it is by a digital circuit, very complex digital circuit. Instruction decoder understand that the instruction which I have received is telling me to read external memory location and bring that data to accumulator, but the instruction is not completely read because it is a 3 byte instruction. So I have to read, means I should read next 2 bytes to know from where to read the memory and put into the accumulator. पुन्हा एकदा मराठीत सांगतो, आता LDA चा ऑपकोड 3A मी वाचलेला आहे. LDA इन्स्ट्रक्शन काय आहे? तर एका मेमरी लोकेशनचा डेटा अक्युमुलेटर मध्ये घ्यायचा आहे, तर कुठल्या मेमरी लोकेशनचा ते अजून माहित नाही. तर पहिले बाइट मला कळलं की LDA, तर दुसऱ्या दोन बाइट मध्ये डेटा कुठन वाचायचा आहे ती लोकेशन मिळणार आहे. त्यामुळे पहिलं सायकल रीड सायकल, दुसरं कशा करता काय करायचं याच्या करता काय करायचं कळलेलं आहे, पण तू ते पूर्ण कळलेलं नाही. सो व्हॉट आय हॅव टू डू, आय हॅव टू रीड मेमरी लोकेशन, बट विच लोकेशन इज येट टू बी नोन. सो नेक्स्ट, व्हॉट डू नेक्स्ट सायकल, ऑब्विसली नाऊ यू कॅन पुट अ पॉज बटन, यू शुड थिंक व्हॉट शुड बी नेक्स्ट सायकल, अँड आफ्टर थिंकिंग यू कॅन अगेन रिझ्यूम, ऑर इफ यू फाइंड दॅट यू आर अनेबल टू थिंक देन यू कॅन डायरेक्टली रिझ्यूम. सो नेक्स्ट मेमरी सायकल वुड बी टू रीड द नेक्स्ट लोकेशन. सो व्हेन द वन्स द प्रोग्राम, it is obvious when you read first instruction automatically you go to second instruction, so you increment the counter of the sequence in which you are supposed to read the instruction. So program counter, once it is used, it is automatically incremented by 1. So you use program counter, it becomes now 1. So again is read, next is read cycle, again program counter, but what program counter will give now, it will give 0001 by, because it is incremented. And what is there in 8085, there is some reverse conversion. The instruction 3A, LDA 4000 is stored as LSB, just a convention. Why in India there is a left, on a road you go by left lane, in US they go by right lane. So here load accumulator, LSB is written first and then MSB. So once microprocessor knows that LDA instruction is the opcode for LDA instruction goes to instruction decoder, next cycle is read from next address, the data here is say 00. Now what this 00 is, remember this 0 means in the second machine cycle microprocessor has read a memory location, the data there is 00. What is 00? 00 is the lower byte of the address from where it has to bring, or it has to read the memory location and bring that data to accumulator. What is this 00? The data which is read by the microprocessor in the second cycle is corresponding to lower byte of the address from where data is to be brought to accumulator later on. So this 00 is available now. This 00 is there at memory location 1. It is available to processor now. Is it required now? No. It is required later on. So in nowadays there is no need of storage because everything is stored on the cloud. So but say 20-30 years back, teacher used to tell something in the class. Why student used to write it? Because it was required later. So what is the need of the concept of storage? That, listen very carefully, each and every word is important. The content which is available now and required later on needs to be stored. Then you will say, are you noting down my lecture now? No, because when you require, it is again available at time, because it is on YouTube. But if it is not so, you would have stored. So what is necessary, when is the exact necessity of storage? The thing which is available now, required later, and not available that time needs to be stored. म्हणजे जी आत्ता उपलब्ध आहे, आत्ता लागणार नाही, नंतर लागणार आहे, पण तेव्हा उपलब्ध नसणार आहे, ती गोष्ट साठवून ठेवावी लागते. लिसन, इज इट क्लिअर? ए थिंग विच इज अवेलेबल, व्हॉट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्टोरेज? The non-synchronization or mismatch between the availability and requirement. Availability is now, requirement is later, means the thing which is not available at the time of requirement is required to be stored when it is available. Is the idea clear? So 00, which the for CPU it is input. So you think that you are CPU, you have put after reset, after a slack is put in a, what you can say, some kind of military school, you start thinking, you put 0000, you got 3A, you understood that 3A is read accumulator, So you are given 0001. You are getting 00. What is 00? This 00 is the lower byte of the address from where I have to perform a read cycle later on to bring the data to accumulator. So this thing is available now, required later needs to be stored. Where to store? So suppose if I go on talking something absurdly and that may or may not be required, then you don't write it into the notebook in the main page. But where do you write? You write at the back page, that is called temporary storage area. So this is also having two temporary storage registers. One is W and other is Z. These are hidden, these are not accessible to the user. So this 00 goes to register Z. Then instruction not yet complete. Then again read cycle. Program count is incremented once it is used. So program counter is given. What it will give now? It will give 0002. What will be there? 40. Where it will go? It will go to W. So now listen very carefully. In the first three cycles, now, what microprocessor has done? Microprocessor has read the instruction. Which instruction? LDA. In the first cycle, it read the operation. In the next two cycles, it read the address from where it needs to perform. So right now, microprocessor is fully equipped with the complete instruction. So it knows that I will read a memory location, which memory location that I also read and that I have put in WZ registers. So what should be next cycle? Actual execution, that is a read cycle. A read cycle. Who will give address? WZ will give address. What is that? It is 4000. And there 33 may be there. Where that will go? That will now go to accumulator. So execution is complete. Right? So in the first three cycles, the microprocessor has read the instruction. I again repeat that 8085 instruction set, I am taking just as an example. Nowadays that programming is not so, means expertise in 8085 assembly language programming is no longer an asset, but that gives you what is assembly language programming. Opcode and all these things, that is you directly give the hex numbers. So at a thematic level it is important. So now what next? After reset, it read the first instruction, and once the program counter is used, it always incremented to point to next. So from address 0 it read 3A, then it came to know that this 3 byte instruction, it read 00 and 40. Then it completed the instruction. What next? Once the when you wake up, go to activity number 1, complete activity number 1, then what do? Go to next activity. You again come to diary, go to next activity. So that is over. So again program counter, it will give, what will give? Say obviously 0003, it is again incremented, and now first instruction is complete. So this read instruction was to know the opcode. Once this opcode was known, next two read instructions were for different purposes. Next read cycle was for different purposes. Now again it is a read. Since first instruction is over, I am again reading as opcode fetch. And suppose let us say 32 is there, that will go to being opcode, it will go to instruction decoder. So 30, so 3A is opcode for LDA, load accumulator, and 30 is opcode for store accumulator. So it is LDA 4000. Now I will have it STA 5000. So load accumulator from address 4000, store accumulator at address 5000.
So again, it is a 3-byte instruction. The immediately the microprocessor know that 32 will go to instruction decoder. It is store accumulate instruction, 3-byte instruction. Next 2-byte test has to read. So what the next few instructions would be? Next 2 machine cycles would be. These are normal read cycles. Program one will give next 2. Addresses 0004, 0005, then 0050. This will again go to same exact reverse of LB. So in next, so after reset, microprocessor read the address 0 for instruction. It read the opcode upload accumulator. It is 3-byte instruction. So it, in 3 machine cycles, it read the instruction completely. In the next machine cycle, it executed the instruction. It came for next instruction now. The next instruction is store accumulator. In 3 machine cycles, it has read the instruction completely. Now, what is to be done? It is to be executed. So store accumulator means what is expected now? Whatever in the accumulator, whatever in the accumulator should now execution of store accumulator instruction will require that microprocessor should execute a write cycle, because accumulator needs to be stored. So when it is write cycle, who will give address? It is the write cycle now. So I am having write cycle by different color. Write cycle. Then who will give address? Store accumulator. Microprocessor has read the instruction store accumulator at. Means in the previous 2 machine cycles, it read the address where to store accumulator, and that address is temporarily stored in WZ register. So WZ register should give the address. What is that now? That is 5000. Because 550 is in W, 0 is in Z. And most important thing is, it is write cycle, so accumulator will give data. Accumulator will give data. What is that? 33. So 33 will be there on address lines, no doubt. 33 will be there on address lines or data lines, but that will be given by accumulator. So this next cycle is microprocessor will put 5000 on address lines. I will put 33 on data lines, and I will activate write bar. So I will read location from 4000 here, 33, that I will put back at other address. So this is the way in which the program flows. There are various other instructions. Now I will explain one very important instruction. Is it that always the program should go sequentially? Not necessarily. So there are some instructions called as control transfer instructions. So for example, there is one more instruction called jump. Jump 6000. The opcode is opcode for jump instruction is C3. Opcode of jump instruction is C3. So C3 0060 is the instruction. So here, after this now, if the next instruction is read, which is fetch, program counter giving 0005, C3 going to instruction decoder, the next program counter giving 0006, program counter giving 0007, then next is 00, that will go to Z, then next is 60, that will go to W. Then this W, internally it will assign, when it reads these 2, it will transfer WZ to program counter, and next program counter will be 6000, and from there it will do a fetch instruction.
Here these are normal read, program implemented, program called implemented.
So with this now, what can be done is there are internal memory locations called as registers, there is arithmetic logic unit. So it is now for you that you can design your own processor. In fact, just like hackathon, we should also have a contest. We can have a contest for designing microprocessor. We can have a contest for designing microprocessor. Once we can have that contest, there are many now. Microprocessor design is now just like what we can say a very preliminary level competition. Understanding 8085 in early 70s was a big challenge. Nowadays it is a high school level game. So you can design various microprocessors. So what is microprocessor now? Something which contains of various registers, some kind of arithmetic logic unit, control unit, program counter. So with the help of that entire, it resets, it reads some, it can write, read anything from any memory location, it can read any memory location, it can write anything into any memory location. So it resets, it reads, there is some coding, what means, which digital combination means what operation, that's opcode. For each operation, you give opcode, you read it, you execute it. But all this thing, so there can be some program inside, and there may be many instructions you can design. But everything which is there is of no use for a common man. Let us say that it is just for the sake of argument, I am a very great philosopher in the world. I am a great philosopher in the world of the stature of say Yogi Aravind, or you can think Immanuel Kant like that. I'm a great philosopher. And I'm supposed to, you are the students and I'm the great philosopher teacher. But the problem is that we meet in the class. I come in the class and I start great thinking. When I start great thinking, I take some theme for thinking today. What would be the future of mankind in 2050? Then I sit in the class like this. I shut my eyes and start thinking. For 1 hour, I have a rigorous thinking. I come to some conclusion and I leave the class. Is it of any use to you? No. Why? Because whatever is going in my brain, my mind, all these things are not seen by you, not perceived by you. A great philosopher like me, I am unable to talk, unable to listen. So whatever is transpiring, happening inside me, is not at all known by you. Same is the case. Something is there inside memory. It is read, it executes, it stores something. So all this memory is not observable by me or controllable by me. Therefore, unless some locations of this memory are user accessible, unless some locations of memory are user accessible, it's of no use. Therefore, in this structure, some is permanently written part, which you can also change. Some is rewrite part, but all this is not seen by the user. But there are some locations at some last part, there are some locations which are accessible to the user. Means those many pins should come out, whatever I write that should be here,
and those flip-flops are there. So inside memory location are flip-flops. So the pins of that flip-flop should come out. So there are two memory locations, let us say two each. I will take last four addresses. Are such that actual pins come out. So these are 8 pins. These are output pins. Means what? When microprocessor stores something at FFFC, this is FF. Its address is FFFC. So 8 pins. These are port 7 to port 0 pins. Then FFD again port 7 to port 0. Similarly, or I at the top as output FFFC port 7 to port 0 pins, or I write in. So unless the memory locations are accessible to the user physically with the help of pins, it's of no use. So a great philosopher like me is of any use to you if I am able to talk, which you are able to listen, or what you want to communicate, I am able to listen. So these are the output pins of memory location FFFC, port 7 to port 0. The next memory location, FFFD. Port 7, pin 7 to pin 0. The next memory location, FFFE. This is the input port. So here you can connect switches. So each pin you can connect, means for this port pin you can connect LED. And for this port pin you can connect a switch. You can connect it to plus VCC always, plus 5 volts, and if you close it, it will become 0. So, and this is port FFFF, again port 7 to port 0, pin 7 to pin 0. So, the microprocessor based system will be of any use to you. So, what is microprocessor now? Von Neumann architecture. Von Neumann has said that with the help of address lines, data lines and control lines, there can be a program which is stored inside the microprocessor and it can access the memory for data. So, Von Neumann architecture is everything about happening.